Dennis Oboa, the government chief whip, was the guest at the function, which welcomed sports dignitaries, including the state sports minister, Peter Ogwang, Uganda Olympic Committee President Donald Rukari, sports commissioner, Reverend Canon Duncan Mugumia, to mention but a few. Uganda Athletics Federation, FUFA, Uganda Cricket Association, Uganda Rugby Union, Uganda Ludo Federation, plus the Federation of Uganda Motorsport, among the celebrated sports disciplines.
Congratulations, Ivan. Of the sport of weightlifting in Uganda for over 30 years, and for his commitment to the promotion of the weightlifting sports in Uganda. Congratulations, Mr. Salim Soke, as one of the long-serving sports.
With efforts in high gear to restore the figures of the sports budget, NCS has bigger plans for the upcoming All Africa Games in August this year in Ghana, plus organizing the 22 sports disciplines set to take sportsmen in Paris 2024 Olympic Games.
A few weeks ago, but on top of that, for producing one of the universities that has continued to win this tournament for the seventh time in a row, and for their good performance in the FASU and FISU games. Congratulations.
We are in the second circle. When I say second, actually the third circle of our preparation for the next Olympics in Paris 2024. We are fast-tracking 22 sport disciplines whom we need to support today and not tomorrow to participate in all the qualifiers in the respective countries that require funding, that require our athletes to be prepared, and we cannot wait for 2024 and government give us money at the last minute. We will not make it. From those gains I've mentioned, we want to request that our resources, which has been budgeted for and appropriated by Parliament, is released. Honourable Minister, in this quarter, I want to mention without shame that the subvention recurrent budget release was only 298 million for 51 federations. Even if you do the best mathematics, you will not arrive where we would be to support these leaders achieve.
How do we collaborate? How do we build synergies to help sports in Uganda to shine beyond what we expect? That's my message as we begin year 2023. I ask the private sector, you are where we are meant to be to help this country achieve all its great potential in terms of sports development in the country. As government, we are committed in ensuring that sports flourishes in this country. For me, as of today, it's entirely to thank you for accepting our invitations to come here to dine with us. As I conclude, true be told, there are challenges, but in my considered opinion, this is not the forum for us to lament. Those challenges are known, and we are here. We are ready to face them head on, and we have started facing them head on. For some of you who are going to be part of the challenges, bear with us, because we have no options but to work for Uganda. But for some of us who are not going to be part of those challenges, please, we call upon you to continue helping the development of sports in Uganda.